cry and cry and try to sleep, but sleep won't come the whole night through. Your cheating heart will tell on you.
Them Ghost Scouts, boys whose names show up on Boy Scout rosters but who are not active in scouting.
Now, the Atlanta area Boy Scouts use those inflated numbers to raise money. Our iTeam senior reporter Del Russell investigates. Del?
Russ, the volunteers we talked to believe scouting is a perfect program for at-risk children in Atlanta's inner city, but they also believe Atlanta Scout headquarters is more interested in collecting names than in helping the boys.
Everybody need to tuck their shirts in.
On a cold night in an empty metal hut, boys from Bankhead Court Housing Project come together to salute their country.
Our pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
These are the members of Boy Scout Troop 685, here to learn about scouting, about values, and about God.
Which one have? Hallowed be our name.
But the men who lead these children say when it comes to inner-city scouting, scout laws like being trustworthy and loyal have been replaced.
The term would be pimping. They're pimping us.
Make your arrow point directly north.
Inner-city scouting has been a buzzword for Boy Scouts since the early 90s. That was when the Scouts unveiled Operation First Class, a program touted in newspaper articles, scouting newsletters, and fundraising campaigns. The goal, bring the joys of scouting into the inner city. In short, Boy Scouts of America wanted to hear more of this. What has scouting done for you?
Well, it have changed most of everything I have been doing, really, and got me out of most of the bad things I've been doing.
Scouts have showed me things that it might take a lifetime for a regular man to take.
The first rule of the Boy Scout law is that a scout is trustworthy. But we found scout leaders who say official Boy Scout records can't be trusted. Records that grossly inflate the number of inner city children the Atlanta area Boy Scouts serve. Numbers those Boy Scouts use for fundraising.
You don't think that somebody's just playing a game with these numbers?
Well, I would certainly hope not. That's not anything that we teach or in my understanding, anything that we practice.
You don't see thousands out there.
No.
These men think someone is playing a game. Meet the leaders of Troop 685, all volunteers working with the boys and Cub Scouts from Bankhead Court's housing project.
We're going to do CPR.
Their leader, Bob Kent. Kent works for the Bankhead Boys Association. Part of his job is to run Troop 685. Kent has seen signs of phantom Boy Scout troops for the past few years. He first suspected a sham when two of his scouts moved to the nearby Bowen Homes housing project and wanted to continue in scouting. He says the Atlanta area council headquarters told him Bowen Homes had an active scout troop.
That was the first time we really began to see that there was something wrong, that there was something going on with a registration process that just wasn't right, because there was no active Boy Scout troop in Bowen Homes.
Curious, Kent began to check the registration records of his own troop. When he looked at the headquarters list of scouts for his Troop 685, he was shocked.
All of a sudden, a lot of other boys just showed up on our list. We'd go down to check our list to make sure it was right, and you'd see 30, 35 new boys on there. This was a few years ago. And, you know, you just wonder where they came from and who did it.
The answer? A former staff member says headquarters pressured scout executives to sign up young boys. And scout executives admit those rosters are used to raise money. Scout rosters obtained by the iTeam show nearly 9,000 inner city scouts in Atlanta. But scouting veteran Cedric Samuels and others don't buy it.
We've never ran into any scout leaders that work with inner city troops on a large scale.
So where are these thousands of boys that I'm seeing on this list?
You tell me. Because I don't know. It's obviously fabricated. There's no doubt about that.
And an iTeam examination of the scout roster show the numbers don't always add up. At Towns Elementary School, the Boy Scouts roster shows 10 leaders. We only found 2 volunteers and 1 scout employee.
I heard that you had 10 volunteers.
Really? No.
and the roster shows 134 boys. During our surprise visit, we counted 14. On the roster that we've got from headquarters, they had your troop down for 134 kids. How could that be?
That's not, I can't answer that.
We found the same discrepancy at Dunbar Elementary. The headquarters roster shows 218 troop members.
The ones you consider your scouts, the ones who come to these meetings and wear the uniform and learn the oath and practice like we saw here today?
Yes.
And that's how many?
That's the 15 that I have.
Ghost scouts, they are called by insiders. Here at Therrell High School, we found a phantom crew. Headquarters shows 77 members. There was an active crew 2 years ago, but not now.
I'm not aware of that at all.
You've never seen any scouts?
No, sir.
How could it happen?
I don't know.
Atlanta area Boy Scout board members Bertram Sears and Tom Gay first heard of the allegations of phantom troops and ghost scouts last fall from the civil rights organization Rainbow Push. The board promptly hired an independent law firm to investigate.
Since some of this has been brought to our attention, we take it very seriously. We take great pride in our programs. We take great pride in making sure that what we say is accurate.
But these volunteers don't believe the numbers are accurate. And they say if scouts raise money based on inflated troop counts, they have deceived the people donating the money, people who thought they were helping inner city scouting.
So if you're saying a scout is trustworthy, and a scout is coming up to you, or a person that represents the scout is coming up to you, and they're telling you this money is for this, and it's not, then are they trustworthy? No, they're not.
A volunteer board member say their investigation should wrap up by March. They tell me an independent law firm that they won't name is doing the job. Tomorrow night, we answer the question, where do those names come from, and how do they end up on scout official rosters? And you'll meet a man who admits he took part in the scheme. Russ, Amanda?
You can see from some of those volunteer leaders, they're very emotional about this. They take it very personally.
Take it very personally, and the volunteers out in the field are absolutely love scouts. It's a battle, if you will, between the volunteers and the paid staff members in headquarters
right.
as to who's doing what and what kind of job each one is doing. But there's no doubt everybody I talk to is a big supporter of Boy Scouts.
All right. Dale, we look forward to your report tomorrow.
Thanks.